Welcome you all to module 3 class 8. Today we will learn about the concept of strings. So string is nothing but a set of characters. We learn about how to create the strings, how to access the strings. Also there are various built-in string manipulation functions. We'll see how we can make use of them by suitable programming examples. Now, string is represented as a character array. Now you can see the syntax here. Char is a data type. Variable name is the name of the variable. Then size specifies the number of characters, how many number of characters can be stored in that particular variable. So an example we are given here, char name, size I have given it as 21, which means it can store up to 20 characters, plus there is a null character or termination character which indicates the or marks the end of the string. Now we'll see how to declare and initialize a string. So there are two ways to declare and initialize a string. Now the first method shown here, char represents the data type. First is the name of the string variable. Then we have specified the size as 10, so it can hold up to maximum 10 characters. And then I have initialized the string first with the values. I have given individual characters here, P, A, B, L, E. So individual characters, you can also initialize it using individual characters by making use of single quotes. In this case, you have to explicitly mention the termination symbol or the null character at the end there. Now another way is, I have given another sample, that is char second. Second is the name of the variable, again size is 10. Directly I have initialized with the value table. I can initialize like this by making use of double quotes. In this case, I need not explicitly specify the null character. Will be automatically appended at the end of the string. Can also represent the string by making use of two-dimensional array. The syntax is given here. Char, there is a data type, array name is the name of the array, and we have row and column, that is number of row and number of columns. So sample example you have taken here, char names is the name of the variable, 6 and 10 is the size I have given, that means it can have 6 rows, and in each row it can have 10 columns, that is 10 characters it can hold in each row. So sample, we have also initialized it. First one, Akshay, Parag, Raman, these are the values I have given. So 6 rows are there. So each can consist of maximum of 10 characters. We'll see some of the restrictions with the strings. For sample example here, char str, I have given size as 3. So now I try to initialize it as str equal to good. Now it is gives error because the size I have given is 3 and I am trying to initialize it with the number of characters here in good is 4. So that's why we will get the error. Another sample example here, char s1 size 4, and I have initialized it to abc. Now string s1 I have initialized it to abc, and I have declared another string s2, again size is 4, and I try to make use of assignment operator, s2 equal to s1. Now this works in case of your integers, but in case of string, you cannot make use of assignment operator and assign the value of one string to another string. That is not possible. Again, another example you are seeing here, same s1 and s2, same example you have taken. So if s1 is equal to s2, that is, I am making use of comparison operator and trying to check if both the strings are same. That also we cannot use in case of strings. Similarly, one more example I taken here. If S1 is equal to ABC, again I am making use of comparison operator and checking whether the contents in S1 are ABC. So that is also not possible in case of strings. We cannot make use of assignment operator and we cannot make use of comparison operator directly on the strings. Now we'll see a program to demonstrate the basic concept of string. That is how to create a string, how to access the how to create the string, how to store the values in the string, how to access the value stored in the string, what are the various ways of declaring and initializing a string. Now here char defines the char is the data type, str1 is the name of the string, and I have given size as 10. That means it can hold maximum of 9 characters. Next, another string I have declared, str2, size I have given it as 10, so it can hold up to maximum 9 characters. Then another str3, another string with size I have given it as 10, so it can hold maximum up to 9 characters, and I initialized it with 2 characters, h and I. Individually I initialized the characters, so I made use of single quotes, and since individual characters I am initializing, so I have to explicitly specify the null character or the termination character to mark the end of the string. Next, str4 is another string I have declared, and size I have given it 10, so maximum it can hold 9 characters. I initialized it with the value as hello. Now here I have made use of double quotes, so the entire string I have initialized. So since double quotes I have made use of, that is why I need not explicitly mention the null character. It will be appended at the end of the string automatically. Next, printf enter the string 1. Now whatever string the user enters will be stored. I am going to store it in str1. So for that I have made use of getS function. So getS function will accept the string whatever the user keys in and stores it in str1. Now to display the whatever string is stored in str1, I want to display that. So for that purpose I have made use of putS function. So putS str1. So now putS str1 will display the contents of string stored in variable str1 on the console. Now getS and putS are the unformatted input output function. So getS function will wait until the enter key is pressed. So it can any string even with the white spaces also it will take, and it will wait until the user hits enter. Once the user hits enter, the entire whatever characters user has entered will be accepted. Now enter the string 2. So now string 2 I am accepting it by making use of the scanf function. So in case of scanf, the format specifier for string is %yes, comma str2 I have given. So whatever string the user enters will be stored in variable str2. Now in case of scanf, whenever it encounters the white space, it will take only that many characters. So we'll see in the output what is exactly the difference as such. Then printf string2 is, so again %s is the format specifier, str2. Similarly string2, string3 and string4 have displayed here. So now we'll see the output here. So enter the string 1. So I've given the string 1 as getS space demo. So now that string is accepted by using the getS function. Then I use the putS function. So putS function will print the content stored in str1. Next, enter string 2. Now enter string 2, I've given the string as scanf space demo. Now I have made use of scanf function here to accept the input and store it in str2. So since scanf function is used, it will accept only until that scanf, that after the space whatever you have given, that will not be taken as input. So in case of getS, it will wait until you hit the enter key, whereas in case of scanf, it will take only until it encounters a blank space. So that's why scanf space demo I have given, but it will take only scanf. So string 2, when I print, it shows only scanner. Then string 3, hi, that we have initialized already. String 4, hello, I have given. So same thing is printed over here. So string length function counts the number of characters present in a string excluding the null character, and it returns the length of the string. The length of the string is the integer specifying the number of characters. The syntax is given here, str length. So that is string length function, and argument it takes is the string name, that is the name of the variable. Now for example, I have taken here char s1, size I have given it as 10, so I have initialized it with the value as hello. So in length, that is to store the length of the string. So length equal to str length of s1 I have given. So now str length function, it will count the number of characters here, hello. So that is 5 characters are there. So 5 will be returned by the str length function, that will be stored in variable length. When I print that, it will display the output as 5. So now strcpy, that is a string copy function. This function is used to copy the contents of one string to another string. The syntax is given, strcpy, destination comma source. So destination and source are nothing but the two string variables. So source string, what you specify, the contents of source string will be copied to the destination string. So for example, I have given here char s1, size I have given it as 10, I have initialized it with the value as hello. Now another string I have created, char s2, size I have given it as 10. Now str copy of s2 comma s1. So contents of s1 will be copied to string s2. So that's why when I give printf percentage s comma s2, it will print hello. Hello is the content stored in s1. Now when we copy the string from source to destination, now if the destination string already has been initialized with some value, then the value will be overwritten. And also we should ensure that the string what you are copying, the size should be either similar to the source string, or else the entire string cannot be copied. And if already the destination contains some value, then that will be overwritten. So next built-in function is strcat or stringcat function. Now this is used for to concatenate two strings, that is to combine two strings. So the syntax is strcat stringcat, and it takes two arguments, first string and second string. So it will append the second string to the first string. Now example, again char s1 I have given it as hello, char s2, there is a second string I have given it as cec. Now strcat stringcat of s1 comma s2, now it will append the contents of s2 to string s1. That's why when I give printf percentage s1, it prints hello, then cec is appended to the first string. So hello cec. So when we use stringcat, we should ensure that the size of the first string is sufficient to hold the characters of the second string when we append it. So it will be appended to the first string. Next, the string compare function takes two strings as arguments and compares both the strings. It returns the value 0 if two strings are equal. Means if both the strings are same, then it will return 0. The syntax is shown here, strcmp string 1 comma string 2. It will compare string 1 and string 2. If they are same, then it will return the value as 0. So now we'll see program to demonstrate the built-in string functions. Now I have executed this program using Turbo C. That's why hash input stdio.h is for the standard input output header functions. Then Here, in case of turbo C, we have to make use of pawnio.h. So, in order to make use of the clear screen function and the getch, if you are executing this using GCC compiler or on the Linux platform, then this hash include pawnio.h is not required. Then hash include string.h, because all these built-in string functions are defined under this header file string.h. Next, I have declared here first string str1 and size as unit as 10, and I have initialized it with the value as cec. Then string 2, again I have initialized it with the value CSC department. Then another string I have declared str3, size as unit as 10. Another string str4, I have initialized it with the value as CEC, similar to str1. Now, I have to find the length of the string. I'll also perform the concatenation. I'll also perform the string copy function. I'll also compare the two strings. So, int length. Length here to extract the length of the string. Then I have also declared another variable cmp. So just to show what will be the result of using str compare, and str compare again will return a integer value, and I'll store it in this variable cmp. Next, clrscr, that is clear screen, because in Turbo C, when you run the program again and again, when you run the program again, the printf statements, the previous output will be shown there. So I don't want that. That's why I am making use of this clrscr to clear the screen. This must be given before the printf statement. This is only if we are using Turbo C. If you are using Linux platform and using GCC compiler, then we need not write, then this clrscr, you need not specify this. This is again defined under header file pawnio.h. Next, printf, I am just printing the contents of string 1, 2 and 4 which I have initialized. Now, I am finding the length of first string. So, strlen str1, and I am storing it in variable len. So, strlen function here will return the number of characters stored in first string, that is 3. Next, I am going to print the length of that first string, so which is stored in length variable length. That's why the length of first string 1 is %d, I have given comma length. Next, length equal to strlen of str2. Now this function will return the length of string 2. So length of second string is, it consists of 7 characters, that is excluding the termination or the null character. So CSEDEPT I have given, so total number of characters are 7. So the function will return number of characters as 7. When I print it, the value of length will display 7. Now, next I have used strcmp, that is string compare function. String compare str1 comma str4. Now this function will compare both the strings. Now if both the strings are same, it will return the integer value 0. So if it returns 0, it means that both the strings are same. If the both the strings are not same, then it will either return positive, indicating first string is greater than the second string. It will indicate negative if first string is less than the second string. In this example, I have given str1 and str4. I have initialized both of them with same value. That's why string compare will return 0 as the result, and that will be stored in variable cmp. Now I am making use of decision making statement. If cmp is equal to 0, if the value stored in compare is 0, that means string 1 and string 2 are same. So that's why I am printing that string 1 and string 4 are same, because I have initialized with the same value. That's why this function, now here it will return 0. Next, string cat of str1 comma str2. Now this will combine string 1 and string 2. Then I am just displaying now combine, and the resultant will be stored in string 1. So it will add the contents of string 2 to string 1. So after concatenation, string 1 is. So now the value of string 1 will be changed. So that's what I am displaying there. Next, string copy of str3 comma str1. Now whatever value is stored in str1, that will be copied to str3. by using string copy function. Str3, I have just declared it, I have not initialized it with any value, so it is an empty string. So whatever contents are there in string 1 will be copied to string 3. Then after copying string 3, I am displaying it %s, str3. Then getch is used here. This is used only in case of your Turbo C, in case of Linux, and using gcc getch, you need not mention that. Getch and clearscreen are defined under conio.h header file. So in case of Linux, in case of gcc compiler, we are not supposed to use conio.h, clearscreen and getch. Getch is used because when you execute the program, again you have to come back to the from the console, you have to return to the program. For that purpose, we make use of this getch. Now we'll see the output here. So string 1 I am printing first, so string 1 is CEC, string 2 I have initialized, so string 2 is CSC department. Next string 4 also I have initialized, so that is CEC. Now the length of string 1 will return 3, so length of string 2 is 7. Now since I have used the string compare, and string compare will return, string compare, there is string 1 and string 4 I am comparing, so it will return the result as 0. So if string compare, if compare is equal to 0 condition is true, that's why string 1 and string 2 are same is printed. Then I have concatenated string 1 and string 2, so the resultant string will be stored in string 1. So string 1 initialized to CEC, now I have done the concatenation, I have added string 2 to string 1, that's why it becomes CEC CSC department. Now string 1 I am copying it to string 3 using strcpy, so that's why now string 3 was empty, now string 3 is CEC CSC department. Next, another variation of string copy function, that is strncpy, which copies n characters from one string to another. The syntax is given here, strncpy destination source n. Now this copies n characters from source string to destination string. Let's see the example here. So s1 string, I initialized it with the value hello, and s2 string initialized with the value cec. Now strncpy s1, s2, 3, so copy 3 characters from string s2 into string s1. So string s2 has got only 3 characters, that is cec, that will be copied into the destination string s1. Now if you can see here, destination string s1 is not empty, it has been initialized with the value hello. So now first 3 characters here will be replaced with the characters copied from s2, that is cec. So if the string was empty, then entire CEC would mean it had been updated with the value CEC. Now since the already S1 has been initialized with hello, it will overwrite the content stored in string S1. I say another version of string compare, it allows us to compare the block of characters from one string to another. The syntax given here, strncmp string 1, string 2, n. So now the number of characters as specified, that is n, will be compared from string 2 with string 1. It will return 0 if the number of characters match. For example, you are given here s1 string cec csc, s2 string cec. So I have given strncmp s1, s2, 3. So it will compare the first 3 characters of s1 and s2. Since in this case first 3 characters are same, so that's why it will print result as 0. The strrev, that is string reverse function, it is used to reverse a given string. The syntax strrev, then string, that is the input string here. For example, I have taken here string 1, I have initialized it with the value hi, and another string, string 2, I have declared. Now string 2 equal to str reverse of str1. So now the str reverse function, it will reverse the string 1. String 1 has got input as hi, it will reverse it, it will reverse string will be ih, that will be stored in string 2. So when I print string 2, it shows the output as ih. So this function can be used in case when we want to check if the given string is palindrome or not. Now str lower and str upper, these two functions are used to convert lowercase string to uppercase and uppercase string to lowercase. And sample example I have taken here, string 1, I initialized it with value high in lowercase, string 2 with value he in uppercase. So I have directly made use of the string upper and string lower in the printf itself. So printf percentage s slash n comma str upper of str 1. So str upper function will convert the input string, that is string 1, to uppercase. It has got the value as high, that will be converted into uppercase, so output will be hi in uppercase. Similarly, I have converted the second string str2 to lower, so the input, the value stored in str2 is he in uppercase, that will be converted to he in lowercase.